Welcome again to this second tutorial for the course English 4. Again, today we're going to be reviewing some of the grammar that you have in your book, Ventures 4. Today we're going to look at the active voice and the passive voice. Let's start with the active voice. It is important that you understand the structure of the active voice. So as you can see, you're going to have the subject plus the verb plus the object. Let's take a look at the examples. The college gives an English placement test twice a year. The college is the subject of the sentence, gives is the verb, and an English placement test is the object. You can also find the active voice in a question. Does the college offer financial aid? In this case, it's going to change a little bit. You're going to have the auxiliary at the beginning because it is a question. Okay, you're going to have does in this case. Then you're going to have the subject, the college, the verb offer, and financial aid, which is going to be the object. For the passive voice, the structure is going to change a little bit. You're going to have the subject plus be plus the past participle. Examples. An English placement test is given by the college twice a year. So you're going to have the subject, an English placement test, be, which is going to be is in this sentence, and the verb in the past participle, which is given. By the college is between parentheses because this is optional, okay, twice a year. Next example. Online classes are offered every semester. Now let's change some sentences from the active voice to the passive voice. Let's take a look at these two examples. Active voice. The bank offers loans every year. Loans means préstamos. Okay? So we have the subject, we have the verb, we have the object, every year. Now, in the passive voice, what is in the object part right here is going to become the subject. Loans are offered by the bank every year. As you can see, we're using the structure. Verb be plus the verb in the past participle. By the bank. Again, this is written in between parentheses because this is optional. You would use this or you would write this if you want to mention the doer. Let's take a look at this question right here, which is in the active voice. Does Carlos paint portraits? Auxiliary does, subject Carlos, paint is going to be the verb, and portraits is going to be the object. Now let's change this question to the passive voice. Now in the passive voice, we're going to get rid of this auxiliary, okay? And we're going to take a look at the object, portraits, and we are going to build our question. Are portraits painted by Carlos? I'm using are because the noun is in plural, portraits. And that's the end for this second tutorial. Thank you.